and they said, how about Kanye West? At the time, Kanye West was a producer. He had produced Guess Who's Bizak for Scarface with Jay-Z on it. He had done, you know, Just to Get By for Talib Kweli. A lot of great, great work, you know? So we were like, in our minds, we were laughing because, like, kind of like Alchemist, you know what I mean? He's just dope producer. Like, okay, we'll go make some shit with Kanye. But what happened is dude was on one and the world didn't know it yet. And he came into the studio showing us, like, this on his laptop, this idea for this song, this video he was going to shoot for a song called Through the Wire, which was, like, early. He was just early, you know? And we watched this video, and I watched the video, and I got the same feeling that I got for Common Sense. I used to love her. Like, I hadn't liked a video and a song so much until I saw this, and I was like, oh, shit. Okay, I see why we're in the studio with this dude. He's gonna do some shit. He was in L.A. I was picking him up every day in my car, driving around. We were kicking raps back and forth. Like, he was on some real B-boy shit, if you ask me. You know, and this is pre-blow-up, you know what I mean? So he came into my house. He had some guy with him called John Legend who was playing his pianos and singing when he could. And, like, it was just early, man. We were just early on this one. We had a whole week booked at the record plant. I remember Kanye flew in and his ears weren't popping off the plane, you know, the pressure when you land. He was like, nah, I just can't fucking hear right. He's like, let me go to bed. Come back early tomorrow and start. So he left for that night, and he left us with four beats or whatever. He was like, I got four bangers, check these out. I think he was thinking that we were gonna pick one of those and just run. And they were good, but we were like, we're here to make a fucking hit. And, you know, now they're putting us back in the room, then we can't just go fucking pick a regular beat and do a 16-bar verse and have Babs cut the hook. We're like, we gotta go do something special. So he came back the next day and was like, are you feeling those? And we were like, we're feeling them, but not really, you know, enough to move forward right now. So he was like, all right, then fuck it, I'm gonna make you some shit. This motherfucker just sat up right there and just started banging out in front of, on his ASR-10 right in front of us, and just, and then these drums he was putting to it, it was like a breakbeat. It was like, it reminded me of Fuck the Police by JD. It was really what it reminded me of, because it was a flute and an ill breakbeat drum. I was going, this is going to be some shit.
What was being said in that was about change around the world. That's something that, you know, in many, many countries, many different languages, people have told me that that song helped them and changed their life or got them through a rough time or whatever. As much as anybody telling me I'm an ill rapper or we killed this verse or that, you know, that Hot 16 was deadly or whatever, when somebody says, like, something actually touched my life, you know, that's even a higher level of appreciation.
Now, I had said earlier, I had to tell him a rhyme earlier that I was saying, you know, I can't live my life this way, continue when we get high. And then it came back a while ago, it was like, of course, I can't live my, he was screaming, he jumped on the console, so putting his hands up in the air, throwing a Rockefeller. I was like, all right, I'm in. Pre-Kanye, you were always real humble. Like when DJ Premier plays you something, he puts it on and then he goes in the corner and he doesn't even look at you because he knows it's so crazy he doesn't have to, like, sell the dream. Kanye was the first person I ever met that was selling the fucking dream. It was like, he was just going crazy. And I was like, yo, this is gonna win. I started getting excited. Rockers, dedicate this to Jam Master Jay, Run DMC, show me how to walk this way. Like, you just get chills. I was like, we're out of here, we're gone. We're gonna take over the planet, you know what I mean? So doing that song, I had just got my first AIDS test. And I was very nervous because, you know, I had unprotected sex with some girl that I was scared about. And so I had to wait a week to get my results back. So my whole verse was on some, I really had some shit to say that day. Even though it was a 12-bar verse, it was powerful.
We got on by not only bringing forth a positive message, but by also staying true to ourselves as what we do. You know, my verse is my verse. My verse could have been on any breakbeat record with a scratch chorus, and it would still been the same verse.
Kanye did his verse. He asked Rock, yo, you think it's cool if I rap on this? Like, he was asking us. So now we have a hit record. Capital thought the same way.
You know, piece of Jam Master J, you know what I mean? Like, it was something that was very important that needed to be said. What was being said in that was about change and betterment and upliftment. And it was done in a way that reached a lot of people.
And they let us have a fucking $400,000 video budget. Anyone we want to work with, Dave Myers, of course, who's one of my favorites, had just done Ludacris Stand Up and all these crazy fucking videos. DMC shows up to walk up to heaven with Jam Master, to find Jam Master Jay with Rocka at the end, and, like, got Exhibit in the video and Alchemist and Twins and all these people. It's just like, yo, this is bananas.
This way, this time, I made up my mind. This time, yeah. I'm back on my—
Yeah,
come on, fellas.
I can't live my life.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like,
right now. You feeling like I'm feeling right now.
That's a song right there. This Way, Dilated Peoples, Kanye West, and the Harlem Watts, Compton, St. Louis.